Hey there, friends. My name is Bjork Ostrom. The thing that I'm going to talk to you today about is one of the ways we save, I would guess, $5,000 to $10,000 a year, and we probably spend maybe 8 to 10 hours in order to get that result. And it's a simple expense audit. And I'm going to show you here a screenshot in Things, which is the task management software that I use. These are actually all the different accounts, bank accounts and credit cards that we have for the businesses, and then also credit cards. Quite a few. It looks really overwhelming. But I'm actually able to move through this pretty quick. I would say it takes maybe 2 to 3 hours per quarter to get through all of these and do an expense audit. And what is an expense audit and how does it work? It's actually pretty easy. I just go into the bank account. We use Wells Fargo, and I'll show you actually kind of real time what that looks like when I do it. And I switch to look at withdrawals if I'm in the checking or savings, because obviously there's going to be deposits and withdrawals. It's not going to be true if it's a credit card, because everything is going to be an expense, but I'm only wanting to see the things that are an expense for the last 3 months. And as I go through that, I ask myself three questions. Number one, is this an expense or is this a withdrawal that can be canceled? And I'm amazed at, even within a period of 3 months, how often I will be able to find kind of leaks in the bucket where we're paying for something we're not using. It's a really easy follow-up. You just go ahead and cancel that plan. The other option that we actually use a decent amount is if there is something that we really like and we want to continue using it, we'll just upgrade to yearly. As you know, a lot of times there'll be an annual plan that's available that's discounted compared to the monthly plan. So that's another kind of self-explanatory, easy step that we often take. If there's a service that we use we really like, we're going to continue to use. The other one that actually has worked more than I thought it would as we got into it was just asking for a discount. So sometimes there's a service that we use, maybe it's a subscription, some type of product, and we've realized, you know what, there's not the ability to upgrade to annual and we still need to use this. So instead of moving on, what we'll do is we'll just send a note to that company and say, hey, love the service, we want to continue using it. Is there any way that we could have a more affordable plan or maybe switch to something that would be at a discount? And I'll give you an example just real quick what that looks like. So I'm going to click over here to Wells Fargo. This is one of the checking accounts that we have. And what I'm going to do is switch over to withdrawals. And what you can see is now I'm looking at, for the last 3 months, this is one of the reasons why I like to do it on a 3 month interval, I'll be able to see all of the expenses for the last 3 months. That's how it works with Wells Fargo. I'm not sure how other bank accounts work. But for the checking and savings accounts, it displays all of the expenses for the last 3 months. And so what I'm doing is I'm going line by line and asking these three questions. Is this an expense that's coming through that I can cancel? Is this something that I can upgrade to yearly? Or would it make sense to follow up with this company and ask for a discount? An example of a time that I did that recently was with our mobile phone service. It's amazing how often they are changing their plans, and they're not going to usually retroactively switch or change or move your plan to a more affordable plan. So if you wanted to try this out, I would say right after this video, you could call up your provider and ask that question. Hey, love whatever it is, AT&T, T-Mobile, Verizon. I'm wondering if there's a more affordable plan considering what we use and what we're currently on. And oftentimes there will be that available. That's the simple process. So it's a quick fix. It's something that I've found to be extremely beneficial. And when you crunch the numbers, when you look at the time that you spend and the time that you're, or the amount that you're able to save, it's pretty easily justifiable time spent, if you ask me. And this doesn't have to be you, it can also be somebody on your team. So I'm going to give you an example here. This is at the end of July, somebody that we reached out to. Just for privacy considerations, I'm not sharing the company name, but this was a message that I sent. I said, hey there, we're trying to figure out how to keep our service bill affordable. Is there any way for us to manage that price or move to a different billing level that isn't as expensive? And their response was this. So, hey, thanks for the message. We hear your concern. We'll do our best to support you. I'm able to authorize a 30% discount on your starter plan monthly rate. You can see it went from $404 to $282. That's almost $1,500 when you look at that on a yearly basis. Another example of when I recently did that, it's going to be harder now, but I went into our bank, and this was with Wells Fargo, so it's a giant corporate bank. And I said, hey, we'd really love to get a better rate on our bank account, on our savings. And they were able to do that and increase at the time. It wasn't like substantial, but it was maybe like to one, a little bit over 1%. So it doesn't hurt to ask. And what I've found is that I'm not going to ask unless I have a system. And the system for me is this massive list of all the different accounts that we have and a reminder for me to do that every 3 months and then to ask this question. Can we cancel? Can we upgrade to yearly? And if not, can we just ask for a discount on our current plan or see if there's something more affordable? My guess is that if you take an hour or two and you do this today or you do it tomorrow, you will find some things that you can either cancel, it'll be automatically money saved, or you'll be able to find some companies that have changed their pricing and you'll be able to either get a discount or they'll be able to switch you to a more affordable plan. And my hope in doing that is that you'll be able to save some money and spend that to continue growing and thriving within your business. Thanks for watching and hope to connect with you in person someday in the near future here when connecting in person is something that's a little bit easier to do.